A hugely controversial film and a rarity this week. A cult film I'd never seen before. The reasons for the controversy and how that led me to not being able to see the film will become apparent during this review. So let's take a look back at Silent Night, Deadly Night, which is a 1984 American psychological slasher film directed by Charles E. Sellier Jr. Set at Christmas. It's a Christmas slasher. Oh yeah, Merry Christmas, everybody. As I said in the opening blurb, this film was hugely controversial on release, and that controversy is probably the most logical place to start this review. Being released at the beginning of November 1984, it actually outgrossed A Nightmare on Elm Street, which opened the same day, its opening weekend. That is about as good as it got for TriStar, because then the controversy started, largely centered around the film's advertising campaign rather than the content of the film itself, with adverts being shown during family-friendly TV shows depicting Santa as an axe-wielding serial killer, which led to a lot of parents complaining their children were now terrified of Santa. This came as a complete shock to the movie's producers, as this wasn't the first, nor was it the last film to depict Santa as a serial killer, with producer Ira Barmack saying, "People have taken offense at Santa being used in a scary context. Santa Claus is not a religious figure, he's a mythic character. I didn't deliberately ride roughshod over that sensitivity, and I didn't anticipate the objection to it." And writer Michael Hickey stating, "I was in no way chagrined by the controversy. I thought it was great. This is a film that could have sunk like a stone and never been heard from again. And suddenly, it was leading the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather. I didn't know how to take that. He may have loved it, but nobody else seemingly did, with crowds of parents picketing cinemas to try to stop people viewing the film. As I've said before and I'll say again, cancel culture, not new, not even close. And Siskel from Siskel and Ebert fame going to such lengths as to read out on air the names of the whole production crew before accusing them of making blood money from the movie and saying, shame on you. First the ads were pulled by everyone in print, radio and TV, then it was the film's turn, with it only managing to last for a whole 10 days before being pulled from cinema screens, having grossed a total of $2.4 million on a budget of around $750,000. TriStar predicted the film would have grossed close to $20 million had it not been pulled from screens. This, of course, all led to the film not even being submitted to the BBFC for classification in the UK, and the sequel was even denied a video certificate in 1987. So it was essentially illegal to view Silent Night, Deadly Night in the country of my birth until long after I had emigrated to New Zealand, with it finally being passed for release uncut in 2009. So I've finally seen this, and does it deserve its infamy? Is it as controversial as the reaction in the 80s would have you believe? Well, dear viewer, I can safely state this is about as bog standard a 1980s slasher as you are ever going to see. It even goes out of its way to set up the whole concept of a killer Santa. The plot has far more build-up and psychological drama in it than most slashers, where the killer is just, well, a crazed killer. Here, Billy the Santa Killer gets at least 50% of the runtime dedicated to his backstory. We open with a young Billy and his parents going to visit his catatonic grandpa at an old people's home. When they inexplicably leave Billy alone with grandpa, he starts warning Billy about Santa and to stay away from him because he punishes people who are naughty. And Billy has been very naughty. And good God, Grandpa is creepy as all hell. He's by far the scariest thing in this movie. So of course, on the way home, when they bump into Santa, he turns out to be a homicidal crazy person who has already killed a shop clerk over the measly sum of $32. He of course instantly murders Billy's father, attempts to rape his mother, then even more inexplicably, rather than carrying that out, merely exposes her breasts and slits her throat. Never really explained how Billy or his baby brother survive either, as we jump cut to a Catholic orphanage several years later. Now, I'm not religious or Catholic, so please, if you are, don't take offence when I say exactly what you think is going to happen when someone says jump cut to a Catholic orphanage happens. Namely, a mother superior psychologically bullying and shaming a small child about his obvious PTSD and growing sexual urges, calling them sinful and they must be punished, then beating his bare ass with a belt, scarring Billy even more. Now, I'm surprised it wasn't this aspect of the film that was controversial, because it is so stereotypical of all the negative stereotypes of Catholic institutions, to the point only a priest molesting small boys is missing. Then we time jump again to Billy being 18 and joining the real world, where he seems to be a wholesome, fully adjusted young man working his way through life in a toy store. An image cruelly shattered by him dreaming about having sex with his work colleague, and him then being murdered by Santa, before waking up in a cold sweat. When his new boss, Mr. Sims, forces him to don a Santa outfit, he seems to cope fairly well, until he witnesses his asshole of a colleague attempt to rape Pamela, who he was fantasizing about beforehand. This makes him snap, and he goes on a killing spree. This all takes about 40 minutes of the 85 minute runtime. Now, the version I own is the unedited version. There's 6 minutes of footage added back in, so the original version was only 79 minutes long. This means more than half of this film is dedicated to the psychological torture of a small child that leads to him having serious mental health issues in adulthood, then due to capitalism, snapping and killing everyone. A situation I'm 100% sure we can all empathise with. This film should be a poster child for how dumb these parent-led movements to ban things were in the 80s and still are now. There are actually various controversial things in the film that they could have protested but didn't, because then, as now, I suspect most people offended never even saw the thing that offended them. The depiction of the Catholic Church as basically being an uncaring evil institution is very in your face. The rape scenes, of which there are two, one of which even has Santa doing it, the just sheer amount of nude scenes, which shocked even me. There are at least 10 to 15 of them. Hell, channel favourite Linnea Quigley is on screen here for all of, 5 minutes. She's new for 4 of those, and then has by far the best death. Still nude. But no, it was the fact the killer is dressed as Santa that essentially got this banned for over half my life. Makes literally no sense, really. Even the kills that Billy dressed as Santa does pull off aren't anything to write home about. If you've seen an 80s slasher, you've seen the kills on show here. Stabbings, decapitations, and impalements. Even though I was never bored, and fairly entertained throughout. Heck, they even make a point of stopping short of murdering children and nuns, even if at least one of those nuns absolutely has been naughty and deserves to be punished. Now, that would have been controversial. The acting effects and cinematography are all fine for this kind of film. The uncut version available on Blu-ray, which I own, does have one major flaw, however. The scenes cut from the original film have all been added back in, but the reels of film or negatives or whatever were improperly stored, so the quality of the picture for those scenes is noticeably worse than the rest, which is very jarring. I kinda wish they'd just not bothered. The gore and effects are again nothing particularly special. If you've seen a number of 80s slashers, about as bog standard as it gets, really. Which just sums up Silent Night, Deadly Night. It's a bog standard 80s slasher that probably would have been totally forgotten about had those parents in the 80s not gotten it pulled from cinemas in the US and effectively banned in the UK until 2009. I still recommend it though, if you fancy a Christmas themed horror, as it's entertaining enough as many of those 80s slashers are. Like, comment and subscribe, because next week I'm taking a week off before returning with my best of and worst of 2021 lists. I gotta get in on that year-end listicle grift earlier than February, which is when I did it last year.